Welcome in the last section of our Building Big Data Stack course, and in this section we'll be looking at the AWS AMR. So we'll be looking at the ETL tools, we'll understand what that tools should do, we'll be looking at the Amazon Elastic MapReduce, this is an AMR, we'll be looking at the AMR API, and also we'll be looking at the Amazon S3 storage. In this video, we'll be looking at the process ETL process. So we'll see what the ETL is, we'll look at the examples of ETL and tools that works as a part of the ETL process. So ETL can be contrasted like extract load transform, which transfers raw data from a source server to a data warehouse on a target server and then prepares the information for the downstream users. So this is a job that loads data from somewhere, transform it, and save it somewhere else. So this is an example of ETL process. So you have a raw source data, it could be some data file, CSV file, JSON file, it could be structured data file or unstructured. And then we have some kind of job that is transforming that data. For example, we have multiple data sources and we want to unify it to one specific structure. So that job could transform every data, every record from every data source and save it to the database server, for example, or to HDFS. So raw data source, our job that is transforming something and saving it somewhere else. So this is an extract load transform or extract transform load. And for example, cleaning the input data is an example of ETL. Because let's say we have file with source data that has two records, city column and state. And in the city column, we have, for example, Baltimore and state Maryland. Then we have Hainesburg, PA and so on. But in the destination table, we want to have state as a shortcut so that ETL job will take that data, load it, transform it properly according to business rules and save that data for further processing or for access by the end users. Or for example, we can perform joins from multiple systems. This is a different example of ETL transformation. So for example, we have some kind of analytics system like payroll data, sales data and purchasing data, and we want to analyze if the specific user buy some product, pay for it and so on. So we can have a job that loads data from those multiple data sources, joins that data, transform it, deletes if something is not needed and save it as a one record for a specific user in their normalized form for further data access. So then it loads data to destination and that data could be accessed, for example, by analytics team, or it could be used for reporting to executive team. And let's look at the standard technology stack when doing ETL. So we have some that multiple data sources like mobile apps, application servers, web servers, ad servers, and so on. And then we have HDFS on which we have that data stored. And our ETL job, it could be MapReduce, Apache Spark, and some or something else. It transforms that data and loads it into data warehouse. Then it could be used for ad hoc reporting using some online tools like REST API or console or something like this. But also we can have a process that works as ETL and is a streaming job. So we have a Kafka data source. So on the Kafka, the events are arriving all the time and we have some kind of streaming job. For example, Storm, Samza, Spark Streaming or Flink. And that process of transforming it and saving somewhere else is constantly working. So this is a streaming approach to ETL. For example, we can save that data to NoSQL database and then it could be accessed by some real-time applications. So the ETL could be batch and streaming. And let's map it to the Amazon stack. So how ETL transformation will look on at the Amazon infrastructure. So we'll have Amazon S3 data storage. So we can think of it similar to HDFS and then we have some multiple data sets, then we need to load it. So we can use Amazon Elastic MapReduce cluster, so we can start some job for example, in Apache Spark technology, submit it to Amazon cluster, and then that job will perform some transformation and will load that data to Amazon DynamoDB. So this is like column-oriented database similar to Cassandra. So it loads data from batch storage like S3, do the transformation using AMR, and save that data to DynamoDB for further real-time applications or low-latency applications that will query that data. Of course, we can have more complex ETL processes. So in this example, we have DynamoDB as a data source, Amazon RDS, or for example, Elasticsearch, S3, Amazon Kinesis or Kafka for streaming data, or Redshift. And every of those two sources could be used for load data to the transformation process and also to store results. So we can, for example, load data from the DynamoDB, do some transformations and save that data back to DynamoDB, but to the different table, to the different columns. So it will be used by different applications.